He's back. Like a bad penny, he's back. I'm going to go back and revisit another track with Rita Coolidge today. She was always such a pleasure to work with, and I did a lot of work with her when she was married to Chris Christopherson. So I did the Chris and Rita albums, and the dynamic between the two of them was great. It was really, those were fun projects to do. I mean, I've known Chris a long time, and he is quite a character. And he would always end up playing 12-string guitar on the stuff because he played so hard that he was lucky if, by the end of the song, if he still had a 6-string going, strings flying everywhere. It was great. So this one, I'm going to read the credits again because I want to make sure everybody gets their props on it. Again, this was produced by David Anderley, who was at A&M Records, and I did lots of stuff with David. David was a wonderful producer. Ellen Vogt was his assistant, and Ellen just made everything run so smoothly. But David was really, he knew what to do as a producer. I mean, he would sit back and he knew the right guys to hire, and then he would kind of sit back and really let it all happen and just make suggestions when he thought it was necessary. But he was a real, real good guy to be in the studio with. And the thing that was great was he was a really gifted painter. And when A&M finally was sold and he moved on, he retired and just spent the rest of his life painting. And I was really glad for him that he got to do that because he was so good and it was such a passion of his. And he passed a number of years ago. That's a sad one, losing him. The song was arranged by Booker T. Jones of Booker T. and the MGs. And it has that whole feel, like a Booker T and the MGs thing. It's great. The background vocals on this were Danny Timms, Kim Carnes, Betty Davis Eyes, and Rita. I'm playing bass on it. Mike Baird is playing drums, Pooh Bear. Mike and I did lots and lots of records together. Mike is just one of the finest drummers in LA. And between he and Willie Ornelas, they pretty much covered the drums on all the Mike Post TV shows that we did. And he's a hoot. He's a funny cat. Dean Parks and Jerry McGee are playing guitar on this. Mike Utley's playing electric piano. Mike, I think, became Jimmy Buffett's musical director for many years now. He's been with Jimmy. And Booker T's playing organ. And it has down as writers Billy Davis, Paul Smith, Gary Jackson, and Raynard Miner. It's a lot of writers. I'm not sure how accurate all that is, but you never know. But I figure better to throw all their names out than not. Doing these projects with David and working with Rita was always really a fun time. You know, it wasn't labored stuff. We got tracks real quick, and she would just get in there and do her vocals. And it was really nice when I was just back in New York with Judith Owen. I guess time really does march on. It must have been, or maybe it was with Phil. God, I don't even remember. This stuff just becomes a blur. But Rita was in the same hotel and got a chance to hang with her for a while and see her. And that was great because I hadn't seen her. We talk on Facebook, but I hadn't actually seen her. And she still looks amazing. She's quite a gal. And so I was always happy to get the call to work with Rita. So here's Your love has lifted me higher, higher and higher. So here we go. I'm going to see if I can remember this rascal now. Thank you. natural fade. Little clamatos there, little clamatos there. I do love Frankenstein. This is such a beautiful piece of lumber. I just love it. Oh, Christ, he's back. I didn't even realize it. I'll have to find out where he's been. Maybe I'll get a postcard in the mail. I don't know. But okie dokie. That's Your Love Has Lifted Me Higher, Rita Coolidge. Got a whole list of other songs I'm going to be jumping into here. I'm glad I got my other video out of the way this morning. I just wanted to clear the air. As I tried to say, I'm loving this. I'm really having a great time with all of you, and I love all the suggestions I get for songs. There's some things that I forgot about, and some people have thrown out about different artists. I'm going, oh yeah, I'll go visit that. But I plan on being here a long time, so I'm not going to run out of material. You know, I can start digging in because I still have Rosanna to do with Toto. I might do Pamela. There's a whole bunch of stuff yet to go there, and I still have some more Phil songs. So have a fabulous day and do it just as good a day as you possibly can. I did a pile of work this morning. I'm going to start investigating things to do with this thumb, because this is really not pleasant. Every time I press on the back of the neck, it's like a little ice pick going in that joint. So I'm going to have to deal with this at some point and sort it out. Been putting CBD cream and stuff on it, and doesn't seem to be making a big difference, but I might not just have done it enough yet. So I'll keep on that. So take good care. The thing that's interesting to me is this is all over the world, because I get responses from people from Bangladesh, from Pakistan, from Japan, from Australia. And I don't know, conditions are different everywhere. The pandemic is a global thing, but some areas are doing okay. They've really adhered to the rules, and their numbers have gone down. And I'm grateful for them for that. I hope people here will get smart enough to do the same thing, because we got a holiday weekend coming up, and people might just go crazy and still think they've got to get out and party. And I just hope everybody uses some common sense and stays safe, because boy, the people in the hot work and everything else are really stretched to the max right now. They're really, under a lot of stress. So let's try to ease their stress a little bit. So take good care. I will see you all tomorrow. And I'm going to talk to him, find out where the hell he's been, because it's weird when they just walk out and don't say anything. But that's kind of like what I did when I was in college. I went on tour with James Taylor, never told anybody I was leaving. And somewhere in a microfilm file there somewhere is all of my all my records, and never used them up, never got my degree. So what the hell? Too late now. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.